today, kids, we have jokes for you. Are you ready? I think so. Okay. Round of applause. Okay, so the first joke. What do you call a sheep with no legs?
A sheep with no legs?
Yeah.
I don't know.
A cloud! Be full of joy in me always. Let everyone see that you are gentle and kind.
The first verse is Philippians 4:4-5, and it says, be full of joy in the Lord always. I will say again, be full of joy. Let all men see that you are gentle and kind. The Lord is coming soon.
There is no shortage of things to complain about. Friends acting weird, too much homework, your terrible lunch. Instead of complaining, choose joy. Choose to remember my goodness. That will keep you from whining away. I understand that getting grouchy seems like the thing to do when life isn't going your way. It's tempting to talk back to your mom or snap at a friend, but I want you to be gentle and kind, especially when you'd rather be grouchy. Mm-hmm.
The next verse is Galatians 5:22-23, and it says, the Spirit gives love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. There is no law that says these things are wrong.
Be happy. Why? Simply because I am near, invisible, yet constantly with you. I am the same yesterday, today, and forever. So there is always something to praise me for. Let me smooth away your frustrations and grumpiness as you think about me and all I do for you. Remember my love and choose joy instead.
That's awesome. The next verse is Hebrews 13:8. It says, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And the last verse is Psalm 107:43. Whoever is wise will remember these things. He will think about the love of the Lord. I don't know about you, Mr. Joe, but I've been feeling more down during this shelter in place mm-hmm. because I haven't been able to do the things I love, like go to the park or go to school or even go to church. I know that I have so much joy when I get to do these things, and I really don't know what I should do when I can't have joy doing these things. Do you have any ideas?
Well, ways to choose joy during this time in quarantine, I would say, is making a cake. You could bake with your family. You could make a card for someone else. You could also play board games. I love board games.
Those are really great ideas. I love baking. I don't know about any of you guys, but if you baked something and you shared it with someone you love, that would probably also bring them joy, which is amazing.
Oh, yeah.
What does joy mean, Mr. Joe?
So joy means the J stands for Jesus, O stands for others, and Y stands for you.
Oh, I love that meaning of joy. Really, you can have joy no matter what you're doing. You can choose joy during this shelter in place. And as soon as life gets back and we go back to school and church opens and stores open, We can choose joy no matter what we're doing, even if we feel frustrated with what's happening around us. So why don't we close our eyes and bow our heads and we'll say a prayer. Dear Jesus, thank you so much for being willing to give us joy, and thank you that your joy is way more than we can ever ask for. And I just pray for Mr. Joe and I that we will both have joy, and as well as all the kids. In your name we pray, amen.
Amen.
Thanks for joining us, guys.
All right, bye.
Bye.